Chest pain could be caused by a number of conditions, but could it be your heart? Dr. Richard Jacob of Mission Hospital in Mission Viejo discusses angina and what these chest pain symptoms are warning you.
Chest pain can have a myriad of causes. Chest pain can be related to heart. It can be related to GI causes, and GI meaning esophageal, gastric, stomach. It can be related to the lungs, or commonly to the musculoskeletal system, to the ribs, to the muscles holding the ribs together. But with any chest pain, you tend to be guilty until proven innocent. The key thing is not to overlook a heart cause or a cardiac cause for the chest pain. And that's why the concern is that when people have chest pain, that they don't take it for granted. Chest pain that's caused from a cardiac cause is substernal, meaning in the center of the chest. It may or may not radiate into the arms or back or jaw. It may be associated with shortness of breath, nausea, dizziness, or an inordinate amount of sweating. The pain usually doesn't vary with breathing. It's not positional. It doesn't change as you move around. It may or may not be provoked with activity. I think what most people think of when they have the chest pain is that this is not normal. There is something wrong. I don't know what it is. I don't know what's causing it, but it certainly isn't normal. I think the key thing in terms of chest pain, I think the most important thing is that people will not know if it's heart, if it's stomach, if it's ribs. All they'll know is it shouldn't be happening. It's different. I've never had this before. This is something unusual. I don't know what it is, but it's not normal. And those are the kind of people who should seek medical attention. Mission Hospital has a chest pain center. And the chest pain center is constructed to optimize the treatment of any patient with chest pain, to rapidly assess them, beginning in the emergency room, and to get them the most appropriate form of treatment rapidly. We've just opened up a new heart catheterization laboratory, and the patient with symptoms of heart disease is rapidly diagnosed in the emergency room, will be moved quickly to the cardiac catheterization laboratory, an angiogram will be performed, and if necessary, the artery will be opened and stop the heart attack from occurring. Time is muscle. If you can get there quickly, if you can respond quickly, if the patient is in the cath lab rapidly, you can actually minimize the amount of muscle damage and stop the heart attack from occurring. Success rate is very high, but the success rate depends upon how quickly we see the people. If we see them within the first hour, our success rate in opening the artery, in restoring blood flow, and preventing the heart attack is very, very high. And the number of deaths we see with acute heart attacks has gone to zero in the first hour if we get the people early enough. Three key things that I'd like to emphasize are, number one, take chest pain seriously. If you've never had it before, it's different. Seek medical attention. Number two is that the speed is critical. The quicker that you can get to a place that can take care of you, the better off you are. And number three is there are things that can be done, not only to prevent a heart attack, but if it's occurring, to minimize the amount of damage. I think if there are three points I'd like to emphasize, those would be it.